This video is going to describe how to import DXF drawings of complex or odd shapes designed in CAD programs to PCB layout and pattern editor modules. But before we start, there are several important things to note. The earlier versions of DipTrace did not support splines at all, but in the most recent ones, software converts splines into polylines, which sometimes may result in slight inaccuracy in the imported drawings. So whenever possible, it is advisable to avoid using splines in CAD designs or convert shapes to regular polygons. However, if splines are present, always check the input results. Also, to avoid input errors, remember to leave only the top view of the drawing in your CAD design. And prior to importing a DXF file to DipTrace, make sure you have closed it in your CAD application. First, I'm going to import a DXF file into PCB layout. I'm gonna use this drawing, which includes a board outline and a cutout. Here it should be mentioned that dimensions and hatching will not be imported into DipTrace. So I go to File, Import, DXF, and browse for the required file. In the pop-up dialog, select the measuring units used in the DXF file. Next, decide about the import mode. If you select New, DipTrace will create a new project, and if you choose Add, the objects will be added to the currently open layout. Let's create a new project. Our DXF file has several layers. To show or hide layers, click on a blue checkmark. Now I'm going to select the layer that contains board outline and specify convert to board outline. Next, I'll select the layer with the cutout shape and once again convert to board outline. In this type of layout, the outer shape will be imported as a board outline and all the shapes within it as board cutouts. Press import button. The board outline and the cutout will appear on the design area. The origin of the source drawing and the layout will be matched. If necessary, you can place dimensions here using Place Dimension tool from the Objects menu. At this point, we can save the project as a DIP file if, for instance, we want to use this board outline in the future, avoiding the need to import or copy it again next time. DXF import is also available in Pattern Editor module. I'm going to import this surface pad. So I select Pattern, Import from DXF, and open the required file. The procedure is mostly the same. In the pop-up dialog, set the DXF units, import mode, new, then select the layer and specify convert to top signal. I need this area to be filled, so I'll check fill closed areas box for DipTrace to recognize closed areas and convert them to filled polygons. I also want a clearance over here, so I tick embedded polygons to exclude this area from filling. Press import button. The pad has been imported. Now right-click on the shape and select Convert to Pad from the submenu.